Hello guys, welcome to my 6th class on discrete mathematical structures, that is module 1, fundamentals of logic. In this lecture video, we'll discuss about NAND, NOR, converse, inverse and contrapositive cases and problems based on it. So first we will define what is NAND and NOR. The compound proposition negation of P and Q is read as NOT P and Q, and it is also denoted by the symbol P NAND Q. The symbol upward will be called as a NAND connective. So next one, the compound proposition negation of P or Q is read as NOT P or Q, and also denoted by the symbol P NOR Q. The symbol downward will be called as a NOR connective here. So now let me frame the truth table for both NAND as well as NOR. So the truth table must have the truth values for P and Q. So let me take the truth values for P and Q first. So the truth value for P is 0011. The truth value of Q is 0101. So now I'm going to find the P NAND Q. So to find P NAND Q, the formula we are having like P NAND Q will be equal to negation of P and Q. Negation of P and Q. So to find this P NAND Q, the first thing is the first one, I must find the P and Q value. So let me find P and Q value. I'm going to apply the logical connective AND operation in between P and Q. So 0 and 0, 0, 0 and 1, 0, 1 and 0, 0, 1 and 1. So now if I apply the negation for this P and Q, I'll be getting what? 0 will become 1, 0 will become 1, 0 will become 1, 1 will become 0. So next is, I am going to find the value of P NOR Q. So the formula for P NOR Q will be given like how? P NOR Q will be equal to negation of P R Q. Right? So to find this P NOR Q, I must find the P R Q value. So let me find that. I am going to apply the logical connective or operation in between P as well as Q. So 0 or 0, 0, 0 or 1, 1, 1 or 0, 1, 1 or 1. So now let me apply the negation for this PRQ. So to find the value of P NOR Q. So the negation of 0 will become 1, 1 will become 0, 1 will become 0, 1 will become 0. So I got the values for both P NAND Q as well as P NOR Q. So problems on based on NAND as well as NOR. So for any proposition PQ of, put the following. First one is P NAND of Q NAND R will be equivalent to negation of P or Q and R. Second one is P NAND Q NAND R will be equal to P and Q or negation of R. Third one, P R Q P R of Q R R Q NAR R will be equivalent to negation P or and Q R R. Fourth one is P NOR Q NOR R will be equivalent to P R Q and negation of R. So let me prove this one by one. First one is I'm going to prove that P NAND of Q NAND R. So it will be equivalent to what actually? So this actually we have the formula like P NAND Q can be written like negation of P and Q, right? So same formula I'm going to use here also. So I'm going to apply this formula here. So what I will get? Negation of P and Q NAND R I will get it. Same thing again, to expand this Q NAND R, I'm going to use same formula. So I'll be getting what? Negation of Q and R I will get it. So now if I take this negation symbol inside the bracket, I'll be getting what? Negation of P R, negation of Q and R I will be getting. So after applying this negation here, for this it will become our operation, right? I'll be getting what now? Negation of P or Q and R I'll be getting. Same thing here also. So I'm going to use the same formula here first. So to expand this I'm going to use this formula. So I'll be getting what? Negation of P NAND Q and R I'll be getting. Again I'm going to expand this one by using same formula. I'll be getting what? Negation of negation P and Q and R. So if I take this negation symbol inside the bracket, I'll be getting what? So it will become negation of negation P and Q. It will become R here. R of negation of R. So I'll be getting what? P and Q R negation of R I'll be getting. third one, P nor, P nor of Q nor R. So same thing here also. So the formula is given like P nor R Q will be equal to negation of P R Q. So same formula I'm going to use here to expand this. So first let me expand this P nor of Q nor of R. So it will become what? Negation of P R Q nor R. Again expanding this Q nor R by using the same negation formula. So it will become negation of Q R R. So if I take this negation symbol inside, I'll be getting what? Negation P, it will become and negation of negation Q R R. So this negation gets cancelled. I'll be getting negation of P and Q negation R. This is because of a law of double negation. A fourth one, P nor R of nor R. So it will be equivalent to what? Same formula I'm going to use here also. So I'm going to expand this. It will be equal to negation of P nor Q or R I'll be getting. Again expanding this also by using the same formula, I'll be getting negation of negation PVQ nor R or R I will be getting. So expanding this negation inside, I'll be getting what? Negation of negation PVQ, and by applying the negation here, it will become and here and R negation of R. So by final, I'll be getting P R Q and negation R. So next one is converse, inverse and contrapositive. So let me see what is this converse, inverse and contrapositive. So consider a conditional, if P then Q will be equal to what? So the first one is, if Q then P will be called as a converse of if P then Q. Negation of, if negation of P then negation of Q will be called as an inverse of if P then Q. If negation Q then negation P will be called as a contrapositive of if P then Q here. So the truth table for converse, inverse and as well as contrapositive. So to prove this, let me take the truth values of P and Q. So P is given like what? 0, 0, 1, 1. Q will be given like 0, 1, 0, 1. So I want negation P as well as negation Q. I'm going to apply negation for both Q and P and Q here. So after applying negation, I'll be getting what? 1, 1, 0, 0. Q will be 1, 0, 1, 0. So I want to find first if P then Q. So it will become what? 0 tends to 0 will become 1. It will be 1. 0 tends to 1 will become 0. Sorry. It will become 1. 0 tends to 1 will become 1. 1 tends to 0 will become 0. 1 tends to 1 will become 1. Same thing. I'm going to find Q tends to P. So 0 tends to 0. 1. 1 tends to 0. 0. 0 tends to 1. 1, 1 tends to 1, 1. So next I need the value of negation, if negation P then negation Q. So 1 tends to 1, true. 1 tends to 0, false. 0 tends to 1, true. 0 tends to 0, true. Again next one is I want to find the value of if negation Q then P. So it will become what? 1 tends to 1, true. 0 tends to 1, true. 1 tends to 0, false. 0 tends to 0, true. So hence here we can see that the value of P tends to if P then Q will be equal to what? Negation of Q, if negation of Q then negation of P. And similarly, if Q then P will be equal to if negation of P then negation of Q. So these are equivalent here. So next problems on converse, inverse and contrapositive. So state the converse, inverse and contrapositive of the following statements. So first one, if the triangle is isosceles, then it is a not equilateral. Second one, if the real number x square is greater than 0, then x is not equal to 0. If the quadrilateral is parallelogram, then its diagonal bisects each other. So now let me see how to write these following statements in terms of converse, inverse and contrapositive. So to prove this, first I must define what is P and what is Q. In the first one, I am taking that P is a triangle, is not triangle is not isosceles, and Q will be like triangle is not equilateral. So implication, so it implies what actually? If then Q will become, if triangle is not isosceles, then it is not equilateral. Converse, Q tends to P. If a triangle is not equilateral, then it is not isosceles. Inverse, negation of P implies negation of Q. So what I can write here? If a triangle is a isosceles, then it is a equilateral. I'm writing here negation of P, if negation of P then negation of Q. So it will become what? If triangle is an isosceles, then it is an equilateral. Contrapositive, if a triangle is an equilateral, then it is an isosceles. Second one, so I am defining p as a real number x square is greater than 0. Second one, q is x is not equal to 0. Implication will be what? P tends to q will become what? If a real number x square is greater than 0, then x is not equal to 0. Obviously, it is true. Converse, q tends to p, we will see. So, if a real number x is not equal to 0, then x square is greater than 0. Yeah, true. Inverse, negation of p. If negation of p, then negation of q. So, if a real number x square is not greater than 0, then x is equal to 0. Yeah, true. Contrapositive, if a real number x is equal to 0, then x square is not equal to 0. This is because of if negation of q, then negation of p. Last one. So, first let me define what is p and q. P will be equal to if quadrilateral is a parallelogram, then q is its diagonal bisects each other. Implication, if p then q. If a quadrilateral is a parallelogram, then its diagonal bisects each other. Yeah. Converse, q tends to p. If a diagonal of the quadrilateral bisects each other, then it's a parallelogram. Yeah. Inverse, negation of if negation of p, then negation of q. If a quadrilateral is not a parallelogram, then its diagonal not bisects each other. Contrapositive, negation of q tends to negation of p. If a diagonal of the quadrilateral is not bisects each other, then it is not a parallelogram. Thank you.